Welcome to One Chemistry. Always try to do your best. Now we will see what is Hoffmann rearrangement. We will see basics, mechanism and fully solve 12 problems. Stay tuned. What is inside this video? Inside this video we will see what is Hoffmann rearrangement. Then we will see basics of it and mechanism, further controlling factors for the product and 12 solved problems from the various examination. The problems containing most prominent and unique examples. So what is Hoffmann rearrangement? It's a conversion of amide into amine. Basically, the alkyl group moved towards nitrogen with the loss of CO there. Here you can see 1-2 groups shift to nitrogen and the product will be 1 carbon less than the reactant. What is the mechanism behind it? It's a removal of CO group as a CO2. The first step will be proton abstraction by base. You have anion formation. Then the anion quenched by bromine cation. Then the next hydrogen also abstracted by the base. You have anion formation. You have anion and leaving group. Hence R group migrate and push the bromine out. So you have isocyanate formation. Then water attacks. Since carbon many hetero atoms, you have CO2 removal. So the final product is amine there. Let us see some facts about the mechanism. The mechanism is intermolecular and concerted. Here you have labeled hydrogen and benzene and toluene moiety. If the mechanism is intermolecular, you have mixture of product. Since there is a concerted mechanism, you have unique product. The product preserve itself and migration and everything happened within the molecule. So you should know Hoffmann reaction goes through concerted mechanism. Then we will see the next fact. What will happen if the migrating group have chiral carbon? The retention of configuration happen, meaning there is no change in the chiral carbon. The configuration S mean it stay as a S there. Since the mechanism is concerted, it is possible. So the retention of migrating group happened there. Then let us see the next fact, kinetic. What will happen if you have electron donating group or electron withdrawing group in the migrating group? What really happens is electron donating group increase the rate of the reaction, electron withdrawing group decrease the rate of the reaction. If you look at the rate, methoxy will be higher, nitro will be lower. So the order goes from mesomeric to inductive. The reason for mesomeric higher is full electron donation. Then let us see the next fact, final product tunability. Here the intermediate is common for everything, but once you change the second reactant, you will change the product. If you use the water, product is amine. If you use the methanol, the product is carbamate. If you use the amine, product is amide, which is alkyl amide there. So you can tune the product based on the second reagent. We will learn the Hoffmann rearrangement through the problem. Here I given 12 representative problems to you. Your learning can be improved by solving the problems. Here the examples will be easy. The trick is just remove the CO from the reactant, you will have final product. See the first example. It's a pyridine with amide group. Just a CO removal, you have amine there. If you look at the second example, same CO removal, you have amine there. The third one is interesting because you have urea. If you use the same, the Hoffmann reaction is possible. You have hydrogen as the product. Even the bulkier group also migrate. That's what our fourth example. CO removes, you have final product. Even acylic compounds with heterocycles also participating here. Hoffmann reaction is possible. Final reaction is amine there. Then the sixth also ring with amide. It will convert it into amine. Then the seventh example. Don't get intimidated by the bigger molecule. The bigger molecule also behaves same. You have CO removal, you have final product. Next, simple amide to amine. The ninth one is interesting because it is a cyclic anhydride, it will convert it into amide there. Then we will see the 10th example, chiral carbon. Migrating group is chiral, mean you have final product also chiral, no change in configuration happened. The same with 11th molecule, it is chiral, change in configuration leads to amine there. If you look at the 12th one, since the mechanism is concerted, the ring is retained. Even though with strain, the ring will not open. Let us summarize the facts we seen. In the Hoffmann reaction, amide will convert it into amine through the isocyanate intermediate. The reagents are bromine and base. Here four important facts you have to know. The mechanism is intermolecular, unconcerted. Then the change in configuration don't occur in the Hoffmann reaction because of the concerted mechanism. If the electron donating group is there, mean the rate will be more. Withdrawing group mean rate will be less. That's all from this video. I hope it was useful. Thanks for watching. If you have any suggestion, comment below. If you really like my video, do subscribe and share.